はい、ということで昨晩からね、1日迎えまして、今日はまあ有名なねシャンパーニュのベルネにあるモエでモエシャンドンの訪問、まあツアーみたいなのをね予約してあるのでこれに来ました。まあモエデシャンドンも有名だし、ドンペリングもね同じ会社なんで日本でも有名ですね。ということでまた中に入って動画撮れたら撮ろうと思います。はい、今はツアーが始まるまでの待合室の、まあ、お庭みたいな場所にいます。すごいな、モエデシャンドン。でここが待合室ですね。水も自由に飲んでください。こんな感じです。ここは廊下ですね。ツアーが始まるねギリギリにしたのでブティックとかもあったのでまあ後で見ようと思いますが、
So Claude Moitié was a very good businessman. He managed to ensure that he would become the official champagne providers of the French royal court at the time under King Louis XV. And his successors ensured we'd become the official champagne providers of several royal courts around Europe. That's why the crown... When you're looking at the pieces, be sure to look at the drawings here. You have some more details about the embroideries as well. And there's always a plaque next to each piece with some explanations.Otherwise, you can ask me. So, as promised, you can explore for the next 5 to 10 minutes, and I'll meet you by the grapes afterwards. Enjoy.
はい、ということで、モエシャンドンのツアーの中はね、廊下とか写真も大丈夫だそうなので、ちょこちょこ撮ったりしてますが。ブドウの実がソースについたり、どういうこと？ワイナリーツアーだよね。この王冠もビンヤード、まあ、畑をモチーフにして装飾がされてるみたいです。なんかワイナリーツアーというか、なんだろう、美術館に来ましたみたいな。
1000ユーロ、900に換算です。だって。
はい、ということでセラーの中ですね。
And then we're of course in the Champagne region. And by law since 1936, you can only produce... Don't go too far, we're gonna go look at something else first, right? So this is the Imperial Gallery. It's named after Napoleon. As promised, we talk about him a lot. So Napoleon bought his first 300 bottles from us in 1800, and he has a very beautiful quote. Napoleon said, "Without champagne, I cannot live. In victory, I deserve it. In defeat, I need it." So every day is a good day to drink champagne. It's pretty good to know, I feel. Yeah. So before we go down the gallery, we're just going to go look over here. Some of you know this already.
壁はチョーク土壌でできてるそうです。
So I'm going to teach you how to read the planchot, the chalkboard here. So there's three lines. The top line is the secret recipe. So only the oenologist and the cellar master know what it says. Yeah. Hi, you.
Have a nice tour.
You too. No ghosts on the other guy. Sometimes workers as well. Might be. The second line is the location. So the gallery and the number right here. So 16, the one is a bit weird, but it says 16. That is where the bottles are. So the first line, what champagne is laying here. The second line, where it is. And the third line is, of course, the number of bottles right here. So 10,098 bottles in this very spot. Yeah? You have a bottle that indicates the number of rows. So there's 9 rows of bottles, which equals 10,098 total. There's some spots with even more bottles. These ones are magnums. They take up a lot of space. So some places you'll see 50 or even 80,000 bottles. Yeah? So keep your eyes peeled during the tour. So here we have Napoleon's barrel, a small present from Napoleon to his friend Jean-Rémy, 800 liters of port wine. So now you know what standards you need for your friends, right? I request at least 800 liters of port wine. When we're standing here, you might also wonder if we ever used barrels to create champagne. So in the past, the first fermentation always happened in a barrel, in an oak barrel. Since the late 60s, so the art piece here was created by American artist Daniel Arsham. He's based in New York. He came to visit Epernay and our house, accompanied by our cellar master Benoit Guez. And everything he saw and learned, he used to create the piece right here. On the far right, you have the barrel, a hint again to this traditional method and to the special champagne that was created for the same occasion, the 280th anniversary. The castle is Le Château du Saron, which used to be Jean-René Mouet's hunting castle. And on the left, we have the goddess of good reputation, La Renommée. We have some stained glass windows with her on it from 1882. So she's been with us for a very long time, and that's why he chose to add her here. Daniel Arsham is colorblind. He only ever works in one solid color at a time. Here he chose white, of course, to remind us of the chalk that plays a key role in elaborating champagne. Arsham has been nicknamed the archaeologist of the future because his pieces look like ancient relics, yet they have this modern touch to them, here with the crystals popping out on either side. His idea is to show us that things can age beautifully and get better over time, which is exactly the idea with champagne as well. The three panels can be interpreted many different ways. I like to interpret it either as 300 years of Moëtin Chardon coming up in 2043, so again, save the date, probably a lot happening then, or three grape types that we use in all of our champagnes, as our idea is to give the world a taste of our whole region. If you want to take some pictures, easy access, you can do that now. So, once the second fermentation is over, we're gonna go get the bottles in the cellar exactly the way they're laying down. So that means all the bottles you see here have been placed by hand and are gonna get taken out by hand as well. In the bottle we have an air bubble, yeah? And the idea is gonna be to move the bottle exactly the way it was laying in the pile. Because if we turn it, we risk some of the sediment falling down and some of it drying out on the surface. We don't want that. So we're gonna go get the bottles the way they are in the pile. And for the cork sealed bottles, we're gonna place them on the pupitre, which is the wooden structure here. So we place the bottle horizontally at first. And then the idea is to turn them, riddle them, as we call it, remuage, until the bottle is on point, sur pointe, which they are now. The idea is to slowly turn them so that the sediment slides down into the bottle's neck, so it's all in one place, so we can get it out easily after. When done by hand, this process takes about 6 weeks. What we do is we mark where the sediment is with chalk, and then the first 3 days we're going to move the bottle, so day one, an eighth of the way and down again, day two, a sixth of the way and down again, day three, a quarter of the way and down again. And the next 3 days, the other way. All whilst also getting the bottle upwards. The reason we only do the bottom half is so the sediment stays in contact with the wine the whole time and doesn't dry out. So we're turning the bottles whilst getting them up. When done by hand, we have a team of around 10 people doing the remuage, the riddling. One remueur, so one riddler, can riddle between 30 and up to 50,000 bottles per day. They do 2 bottles per second simultaneously. So what you do is you do take bottle number 1 and number 4 and turn them, 2 and 5, 3 and 6, then you go down, until you reach 30,000. Yes? So you have to be very good at multitasking and being very efficient. The capsule sealed bottles, we're going to place in metal cages. One metal cage can hold 504 bottles. The cage goes on a robot, and in less than a week, it's turned upside down. For the capsule sealed bottles, there's a little plastic cup inside called un bidule, a thingy, that receives all the sediment. For the cork sealed bottles, the sediment will lay on top of the cork. I'm gonna let you come and see what that looks like for yourselves, so you can come on over and have a look. There.
Soft.
シャンドンのツアーがね、だいたい終わったので、最後ブティックですね。 こんな感じですっていうね。そして、終わろうと思います。エプロンとか持ってるぞ。どういうこと？アイスインペリアね。なんか氷を入れてちょうどよくなるように作ってるワインみたいです。フランスの国旗になってラベルは。いや、イメージがすごいな。イメージがはね、もうはっきりもう大量生産だし、まあグランドクリューとかもあるみたいですけど、なんでこんだけ保ってるのはすごいですけどね。ざっくり、こんな感じです。シャンパーニュのランスからもうちょっと下南の方に、30分ぐらいかな、車で走ればモエシャンドンに着くので、まあまあ面白かったので来るのも面白いかなと思います。モエシャンドンのツアーとブティックはこんな感じでした。